I am here! I'm here, guys! We're live in Minneapolis, Minnesota! I am proud of our new SmackDown champion. Aren't you?
It's weird, it's unexpected. Why?
Because that's who I pick as my last guy.
Oh,
yeah. Oh, well. They didn't see nothing. Ha!
Why?
They didn't. That's all. Yeah. You guys will find out what the surprise is. Huh? So you want to say what our main event is tonight? We already know if they watched No Mercy.
Tonight's main event, I did not agree on this. Sadly, that's not good. Skullkery will be facing Heath Slater. Slater wins and gets a title shot at SummerSlam.
What an awesome first title defense that would be. Heath Slater. This is the land of opportunity, right? Mm-hmm. Looks like we're going to start the show with John Cena, though. What's Big Match John got to say? Because 1 week ago, he lost his SmackDown Championship because of Heath Slater. Heath Slater got caught in the coquina clutch last week. I unfortunately missed SmackDown last week. So, since Joe lost the title, does that mean Cena's out of a title rematch?
I feel like that might be the case.
I mean, you're the general manager, you can make the call. I'm sure John Cena's willing to earn it back.
To be honest, it's a journey. I don't know where it's going to go. I like to see what Cena has to say.
Don't stop believing.
Not that journey. Anyways.
The Joe Tucker.
Not that journey. Holy different journey.
The former champ is here.
Please welcome John Cena.
It looks like he's in business mode.
Forgot or fell off, I'm still hot, knock your shell off. My money stacked fat, plus I can't turn the swell off. The franchise doing big business.
Thank you for the warm reception. I really appreciate it. As much as I love to sit here and bask in the adoration of the WWE Universe, I've got something on my mind. I need to pay off my check.
I have a feeling I know what that is. Of course, you miss No Mercy kickoff, you don't know what it is.
If there's one thing I can't stand, being disrespectful. WWE superstars don't all have to like each other. In this ring, we shall have a modicum of respect. Lately, though, I've noticed someone disrespecting you. When you disrespect me, you disrespect the entire WWE universe. I'm going to sell this once and for all. Kurt, get your ass out here so I can show you and Mankind Don, the one that deserves everything you have.
Here comes the Olympic gold medalist.
Here
off guard and out. Why is he impressed with me? Is he in a match point?
Not like I do. Exactly the fast I remember you.
You're right not to be surprised to see me. I haven't forgotten what's happened between us. I sure as hell know you haven't forgotten either. So we're gonna talk about it here, and I'm gonna show everyone why I am a better superstar. Oh, it's real. It's damn real.
Okay, so it's real. Probably as real as the fact that they'll just hand anyone a microphone around here, even a walking fucking caveman like you. You honestly believe what you just said was interesting and impactful? Having a WWE universe like me dozing off in the bedroom. Just listen to me.
Impactful, huh? You must have watched my old matches from 2006 to 2013. But I'm sick and tired of being overlooked, ignored, and dismissed, especially by the likes of you. I brought you in, and I'll take you out. Got that? Champ?
This is actually getting embarrassing. I'm cringing right now. I think you better plan your way somewhere else. Because no one is buying the crap yourself.
Kurt Angle made a fool of himself Saturday when he called out John Cena. If you want your ass kicked, then don't mind me helping you out with that plan. All you gotta do is say it in the words, and I'll be on you like white on rice. Word life!
Big words, little man. Mark my words, we're going to play a tiny portion next season. When we do this, we're going to be pulling you out on a stretcher. And you need to say something right about putting on this.
Dear God, this city is disgusting. Everyone here is trash. You're all a bunch of ignorant integrates, barely capable of tying your own shoe. I've seen pigs who are cleaner than all of you, and ants who are better behaved.
This city and these people may be a crap man, but then again, so are you.
So we just call this.
You can make fun of them as much as you want, I don't care. But you're in the ring with me tonight, and I'm taking full advantage.
No, I thought you guys weren't fighting me. I can't believe this. How dare you and the WWE fans try to goad me into a confrontation. I don't have to prove myself to any of you. As far as I'm concerned, you can all go to hell. Goodbye.
Well, that's not the last word tonight.
I can't believe Cena said these fans suck.
Ralph, I think he was in the moment. I think he was more focused on Kurt being an angel.
Looks like kicking off the show, we got Batista taking on Cesaro of the Bar. Batista lost Sunday in a steel cage match against Bray Wyatt. I don't know if you know this, but he's the Eater of Worlds. I wasn't there, so Why don't you tell me about what happened there?
It's really unusual that you weren't here, but anyways.
I had a cold.
Batista, you thought that Bray Wyatt would be trapped in the cage with the animal. It was the other way around.
He's the eater of worlds. He's got the whole world in his hands. Apparently he's got the SmackDown universe in his hands because they're all his fireflies.
Indeed.
SmackDown edition. Cesaro's not only strong, he's also quick. He's not Neville. Wow, I hate when he does that. He's not Neville. Nobody is Neville. Not even Neville is Neville.
Leg drop.
Shades of Hogan. Speaking of Hogan, I don't like their absence at least since they've been drafted by this team. Running your European uppercut. Like, stop doing that! Batista sent to the outside, right where Sheamus is. Batista not taking it from Sheamus. A belly punch. Lefts and rights. Stop! You don't get... It doesn't bother you? The Irish whip into the corner. Cesaro sidestepping. The belly-to-belly Batista counter. Now it's the animal in control. Alley-oop! Talk to us about Batista.
Oh, I mean, of course, he's not. Guardians of the Galaxy or anything that would
be able to do. Pop up uppercut! Another uppercut! Cesaro's uppercuts or something else.
As I said.
Batista ran right into that one. Also, one of the key elements of SmackDown, Batista might be going for a swing! Eight revolutions from Cesaro! Take a replay. That's 290 pounds just being swung in the circuit. Can you do that? Yes. Cesaro goes for the cover. And he got it!
Ooh.
That's a big win for Cesaro. Get that black hole slam. Batista, that didn't... Cesaro swings. Superman is the... We gotta drop all this.
Here's your winner, Cesaro!
Victorious. congratulations to Cesaro. What is this? That graphic says SmackDown Tag Team.
Oh, yes. Wow.
It shouldn't say World Tag Team Champion. It says SmackDown.
How would they do?
I have no idea. So, let me get this straight. Tyler Breeze and Fandango earned the right to challenge the tag team champions for the titles in SummerSlam by winning two individual battles. However, how is that happening? That's the only match the Bludgeon Brothers have lost thus far. It wasn't even as a tag team. They enter that individually. WWE Universe swaying back and forth. Does that answer your question? It would appear that they went out and got some money.
Hey, it's a funny design.
They obviously went to production too. Graphic change.
Sucker.
tag team. He defeated him in the rematch. This is a tag team bout set for one goal, and it is for the SmackDown Tag Team Champions. Representing Paul Wyatt, at a combined weight of 590 pounds, Harper and Rowan, the Bludgeon Brothers! And their opponents, representing the Main Event Mafia, at a combined weight of 506 pounds, they are the current SmackDown Tag Team Champions, the Icon Sting and Booker T! Sorry, Dick, you're on a time clock there. Well, I guess this is for the brand new blue strap title. Mike is shaking his head here. You really do not like Shane and Vince, do you? Super kick! Another one! And a big boot! I'd say the Mafia's tag team titles haven't been in more danger than they are right now. Jawbreaker from Sting. Tag to Rowan. And a big boot. I'm assuming Sting and Booker. I'm assuming you have favoritism in this match for the Bludgeon Brothers.
Most likely. Mafia's been running amok.
At one point, they had all of SmackDown's championship minus the Hardcore title. That was last week. Sting sent to the outside. So is Booker T. They do that. Sidewalk slam. Team from the Bludgeon Brothers.
No.
To the ring post. Welcome to NXT vs. SmackDown, SmackDown Live. Next thing you know, they're going to be running around in suits saying they own the place. Yeah. Skullkery standing vertical suplex, bring Rowan back in the ring.
Probably a rope break.
Or not.
Despite the fact this is clearly on the bottom rope.
Over the top. DDT!
Hope it cuts off the hot tag.
Welcome back to NXT vs. SmackDown, SmackDown Live Edition. I am the general manager of NXT, the future. That's Mike. Over there is Dick. And that's the main event mafia.
T counters.
Eric Rowan desperate to need the tag.
Over.
Oh, sure. Now he wants to call the referee.
The worst could be the referee.
Could be the NXT referee.
I still don't like it.
The spinning heel kick! The Bludgeon Brothers might be closing in on the SmackDown Tag Team Championships! This could be it!
Actually, wait, no, I come to think about it, I haven't seen him at all.
Well, where would you be able to find said Bray Wyatt?
I have none the slightest clue.
I don't even know where you can find those two. Coming up next, we have Shinsuke Nakamura taking on Elias.
Well,
Nakamura. Elias is probably going to be part of it.
Yeah, you're up for the big one.
Or wherever all the
noticed. That's a guitar on the ramp.
You just noticed.
I just noticed that. I noticed the the Superstore. I never know. I'm gonna sing y'all a song. But first, I have a question that needs to be answered. Minneapolis, what does WWE stand for? I said, what does WWE stand for?
You're off saying it yourself.
Well, if y'all aren't gonna give me the respect, I'm not singing y'all a song.
Good.
Ran right into the dropkick from Shinsuke Nakamura. Belly. Oh yeah, by the way, I heard a rumor. Well, Roman Reigns is no longer the next top guy.
Oh, thank fucking goodness.
Braun Strowman.
Thank goodness!
I also heard another one.
What?
Elias is being built as the
second top guy. That's actually pretty good. One, it's kind of refreshing. Two, it's Elias is pretty good.
Elias, what you doing there?
Who wants to walk with Elias? Definitely not me.
Elias had a great debut. He lost. He had a great debut. It's Jeff Hardy. This past Saturday, he just beat Daniel Bryan. Elias dropped right on his head.
Or he does.
Elias once again rolling to the outside. Bulldog! Back in the ring. Elias counter! Little bulldog!
Oh, nice.
Elias tripped away!
Nakamura kicking out at two.
Why is he this weak here?
Shinsuke's bleeding now. course, he's gonna chit chat with the ref. Elias in control. He's just gonna sit on the top rope. That's a new one.
Oh.
Elias, pendulum backbreaker. Cover. Elias knew better. Another discus forearm. Knee drop across the neck of Shinsuke Nakamura. Well, I think that's enough. Not even. Well, I is now has 69. With that scoop slam. The knee. Elias moves fast. Can't hit the Kinshasa if your leg's out. Mission.
You can't imagine stopping.
Leg. Parting knee. Inside cradle. Elias kicks out. DDT from Nakamura. Rope break. Elias' right foot was under the bottom rope. Went for the drift away. Crossroads. Elias covered. Got him.
Wait, what?
It's Shawn Michaels!
What?
So Shawn Michaels giving Shinsuke Nakamura a round of applause. Okay. Sure. Let's go with that one.
This is interesting. I wonder what's going to happen next.
What is this? Oh, wait, I know the context behind this.
Three out of the five members for the history and Benjamin gets his whole shot.
He's got three chances, three strikes, he's out. He loses three matches, he's done. He ain't getting a shot, some kids. Three strikes, you're out. Looks like it's gonna be Benjamin taking on Matt Jackson of the Bullet Club. Here's my question. Are they gonna come out to the Bullet Club music? Or are they gonna come out to the club music? Or are they gonna come out to their own music? I'm hearing it.
Number one fall. And it is the first match of the best of five series of the Invention Invasion and the Omega at SummerSlam. It is basically first from Orangeburg, South Carolina, waiting now. Chelsea, Benjamin.
Former Intercontinental Champion, knocking off on the Giant. Shakes Matt Jackson's hand. Seen a lot of handshaking on 205 last night.
To be honest, this is a great way to start things off.
Super kick! Himself left WWE, went to New Japan.
Oh,
I believe he's doing the crab dance. Benjamin over the top rope! And there goes Matt Jackson! Second time in a week he's going over the top rope.
First time actually mad.
And he's over the top again. Benjamin got up. Oh, he hit the turn. He hit the corner of that table.
Okay, let's just look at this. What?
He hit the corner of the table trying to hit Matt Jackson.
Yeah, let's look at this. Oh, what? He was obviously off by a long mile.
I posed the question, can Benjamin lose this match?
Will it really affect him? It'll only affect him because it'll be a loss.
I know, but does the loss matter? Can he afford to lose? Super kick! No! He beat him to the kick! DDT! I posed this question now. The bullet club really fun.
Because all you want is...
Super kick!
Like the elite are flying, but I don't know what the rest.
Clothesline from Benjamin. And he goes for the cover. Now Jackson's bleeding. Looking to capitalize. It'll take a little bit more than that to keep Matt Jackson. Keep in mind, he is a member of the Young Bucks. No, he went for the painter. Super kick. He's doing crab dancing. Nick Jackson just threw a chair into the ring. Super kick! DDT! Matt Jackson not done? We knocked the ref down. Benjamin, what you doing? Nick Jackson has helped Benjamin back to his feet. Shelton doesn't trust the Bucks. Nor should he. The Meltzer driver. Benjamin seen the super kick coming.
Benjamin, no.
And his head just landed on that chair.
I wouldn't use that chair if I were you. What the hell is he doing?
Went for the painter again. Inside cradle. Benjamin takes out. It was Nick Jackson who introduced the steel chair into the match. Benjamin's getting frustrated.
Oh, really?
Schoolboy!
That's what he's looking up.
And another schoolboy, that's what he's super kick! The super kick party is wild tonight in this match. Cover! And Nick Jackson again! Benjamin's seen enough. Went for Painter again! Can't seem to land it! Super kick! That would be the difference made Nick Jackson again!
Wow, at this point, he gets kicked out.
Look for Painter again. DDT! You gotta make a call on that. You can't have them ringside. Out. This is just going to be a common nuisance. Off the super kick into the spinning heel kick.
Cover.
Hey, God. Super kick. There you go, Nick. You want to get involved?
Out.
cover. Kick out.
Hitter.
Big boot. Benjamin, what are you doing? Maybe it was a ploy. Went for Painter. Hang him up to dry.
Cover.
Kick out. Ref, how much more are you going to let this happen?
Could be worse with the axe, too, though.
Good point, but still.
That's the point.
Matt would have been done by now. Nick Jackson would be getting involved. Caught Benjamin off guard.
Cover.
Benjamin kicks out. Benjamin wants this United States Championship match. Meltzer driver inbound.
Bummer.
Can't seriously let them both be out there at ringside next time. That's unfair to Benjamin. It's supposed to be one-on-one. That's a two-on-one handicap match right there.
Your winner,
Matt Jackson!
It's only the first match, so it's just begun.
Again, he's got to win three straight. You're going to ban Matt from ringside?
Yep.
Good plan. I see what they see.
I still want to go. so I had to dip.
I've been all over the world and I've faced the best competition and some of the biggest venues on the planet. Still, I find myself having to come out to places like Minneapolis, Minnesota, and it's embarrassing, but it is what it is. I love him, I hate him, I respect him, I want to ruin him. I can't help it. He's been stirring my emotions so much, but there's only one recourse of action here. I destroy him! What better place for his destruction than right here, right now? Me, I live every day, like I ain't got no time to waste. Time is a commodity, and it's valuable to me, so let's stop wasting it. Get your ass in this ring so I can choke you out.
Trying to choke me out. You're just probably mad because you lost your title. Hey, look, I'm not pleased about who won that match, but you don't take it out on me.
You know who you remind me of? Little Ronnie Tonko. Back when I was in first grade. He was a snot-nosed punk, always whining and complaining. Everyone would pick on him because he was weak. He would never defend himself. He was a loser, just like you.
What? So, a loser, huh? Well, it's great hearing about this imaginary friend of yours back in elementary school, but this is the ring. We're not talking about your imaginary love interest. Back then. We're talking about what's going on right here and right now.
Samoa Joe!
What?
He just attacked Mike! This might take Mike out for the rest of the night. Samoa Joe is gonna regret this! You guys didn't even get to see that, but it's Samoa Joe just attacked Mike. What is this place turning into?
I don't know.
I just received a phone call. I gotta go.
Well done. Anyways, next up, it's Kazuya versus Cody. You know, good old Cody Rhodes. He showed up in No Mercy, but sadly, was attacked all of a sudden by Luke Gallows. Like, he says Bullet Club is fine. Is that what you call fine? Like, he attacked you from behind. Took Finn Balor's place. And made you bleed. I mean, come on, man. Following contest except for one fall and making his way to the ring first. Wait. What? What? Where the hell is... And Cody was attacked from behind by Carl Anderson. Where the hell did Kazuya go? Did he get overpowered? By Carl Anderson? What? Insane. What just happened? I'm like in that short amount of time. Shockingly, he won't be here for the rest of the night, of course. I mean, I wouldn't be here too if I got low blow like that. Anyways, we obviously know who Joe's after. Next up is the main event here. This unknown enigma. Skullkid, who literally appeared out of nowhere and won the SmackDown title. And he's going to be going off against Heath Slater of all people. But Mike is branded as a friggin' idiot. Which I don't mind. I forget if he put Slayer on the frying pan or not. I don't think he did yet. I swear we need to have a list. I'm just one man, but I'm the one man. All contest except the one fall, making the way to the ring first. He is the new SmackDown champion. Everybody always runs and hides, screaming for protection. Do what they say to get you on their side, like buying food stamps on the election. We're now just where we stand. We're taking
Slater!
Skull, so I'm sure that wouldn't hurt too badly. No. Slayer does Mike didn't set things up.
Cover! I'm just one man. But I'm the one man.
Yeah, that's all you.